हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एपिथेलियम। सो बिफोर डिस्कसिंग द एपिथेलियम वी शुड नो अबाउट द टिश्यूज। सो व्हाट आर द टिश्यूज? सो टिश्यूज आर नथिंग बट द एग्रीगेशन ऑफ सिमिलर टाइप्स ऑफ द सेल्स एंड मटेरियल सराउंडिंग देम। सो नाउ व्हाट इज एपिथेलियम? So epithelium is basic tissue of our body and it consists of cells which are arranged as a continuous sheets. In this epithelium, the arrangement of the cells, this may be in a single layer or in a multiple layer. Now let us take an example. Suppose this is a epithelium formed by similar type of the cells which are similarly in size and shape as well as in the function, and these are the nucleus of the epithelium. Now here you can see the cells which form the epithelium, they having a two lateral surfaces as well as the free surfaces and as well as the basal surface. So the cells which forming the epithelium, they are closely opposed to each other on its lateral surface. Here the cells are tightly close to each other in its lateral surface. So here on its lateral surface, the cells are connected with each other by a cell junctions. Now the another surface of the epithelium is the free surface. So this free surface, it is exposed to the body cavities, right? And it is also present at the lumen of internal organs, and it is present at the external surface of the body. Another surface of this epithelium is the basal surface. Here you can see this one is the basal surface. So this basal surface, it adheres to a thin continuous supporting layer which is called as the basement membrane. It is also called as basal lamina. Okay, so this is general structure about epithelium. Now let us discuss about properties of the epithelium. So properties of the epithelium, first property is it is avascular, which means it do not have any blood supply. So how it receives blood supply? It receives the blood supply or nutrition from the capillary which are present into the basement membrane. Next property is it is nervous, which means it do not have any blood supply, but it is supplied by nerves. Its another property is it having a high capacity to regenerate. It having a high capacity to regenerate, as most of the time it is subjected to wears and tears. Okay, so this is about the epithelium. Now let us discuss about the functions of the epithelium. So its first function is the protection. So as we already know, the skin is the barrier between the surface of our body and the external environment, so it protect our body. Okay, another example is of the protection is it lies in the body cavities, so it also protect it. Another function is the absorption. Some epithelium of the organ like kidney and intestine, they are absorptive in nature. Next function is the, it act as a barrier. Here let us take an example of the urinary bladder. So urinary bladder, it resists the absorption of water. Another example is the skin. It also acts as a barrier to the external environment. Next function of the epithelium is secretion. Here the epithelium of the some portion of the nephron of the kidney, they are involved in the excretion of our waste product. So example is the nephron of kidney. Another function is the secretion. Some epithelium may also act as a secretory, just like example is the intestine. Another function is the detection of sensation. Some epithelium along with the nervous tissue, they form a special sense organ. So they may form a present in the ear, nose, and hearing, smell, and the vision. These are the our special sensation. So these are the functions of the epithelium.